Supervisor of Elections Building in Leon County, Florida. Then Andrea Jenkins, self-advocate.
I'm Andrea Jenkins. I live and work in Tallahassee, Florida. I am wearing a blue dress with a cardigan, black cardigan, and I have hazel eyes and blonde hair.
Hi, my name's Alex Mosca. I'm a public information specialist with the Leon County Supervisor of Elections. I'm a white man, I'm 39 years old, and I have gray hair. Each eligible American citizen has the right to vote in an election. And one in four adults in the United States has some type of disability, making it important to ensure that all voting sites have accessible voting machines for all to be able to exercise that right.
People turn in paper ballots at a voting center. Andrea.
People without disabilities may take the privilege of voting for granted. However, the regular ballot isn't accessible to individuals with disabilities.
Ensuring accessible elections is a part of what we do. That's why we've made it a part of our mission statement. And the Help America Vote Act requires at least one voting machine in every polling place be accessible to anyone with a disability.
A poll worker sets up an accessible voting machine.
To use the voting technology, we make sure to train our poll workers so that they know how to use the machines, where to locate them to protect voter privacy, and inform voters that they are available.
A poll worker guides Andrea to a voting machine and shows her how to use the machine, as Alex explains.
When you arrive to vote, inform a poll worker that you need to use an accessible voting machine, and they should direct you to an available option. Remember, voting accessibility is your right. In this video, we'll go over the features of the ImageCast voting machines, which is what we use here in Leon County, so that you can be prepared to vote.
An ImageCast voting machine featuring a screen and panel of buttons.
The ImageCast machine was designed for accessibility, which means that voters with disabilities can cast their ballots using the standard equipment we have available at every voting site in our county.
Andrea.
Have no fear. It's a very simple process. They will help you to get set up and get oriented to the machine and how it works.
A poll worker inserts a paper ballot into the machine.
We will cover an overview of the device. The ImageCast machine provides voters with several accessibility features, including a large screen to better view and cast the ballot, assistive input devices for accessible ballot navigation and voting, including a keypad, headphones, sip and puff, and paddles.
Audio instructions from the machine.
Please select your assistive input device. You have chosen to use the audio tactile interface.
A user keypad, also known as an audio tactile interface, or ATI, is a handheld controller that is used during voting. It is connected to the ImageCast machine, and a set of headphones can connect directly to the controller. The keypad also includes T-coil coupling, a device that works with hearing aids and cochlear implants to couple with assistive listening devices, audio systems, and cell phones. The ImageCast machine has a T4 rating for interference. If you have your own preferred accessible equipment, including paddles, sip and puff devices, or T-coil couples, you may wish to bring them with you when you go to vote. You can then use your own accessible equipment when interacting with the voting machines. If you are blind or have low vision, the ImageCast machine provides additional accessibility options. First, the visual display can be adjusted using the zoom and contrast buttons. There are three different zoom levels to enlarge the screen for individuals with low vision, and the contrast button allows users to view text and informational graphics at a higher contrast. The machine also has a privacy mask feature, which allows the voter to use the audio functions only and black out the screen for additional privacy. The keypad is accessible for blind voters because of the raised keys and braille text identifying each function. The ImageCast machine can read the ballot aloud through headphones.
To vote in this contest, press the blue down arrow.
This can benefit voters with blindness and people with low vision, and also people with invisible disabilities, like learning or intellectual disabilities.
As someone who's visually impaired, I utilize the ATI, which speaks out the selections, and that allows me to make my selections confidentially.
Once you're ready, the poll worker should then step away, allowing you to complete your ballot in privacy, a right that all eligible citizens should be able to access.
Prior to learning about the accessible voting machine, I would have friends try to assist me with the voting, and it didn't seem very private or discreet, so it's wonderful to be able to have the option of voting on my own.
The keypad contains raised buttons that can be identified by touch by their different shapes and visually by their bright colors. The buttons on the controller include a red X-shaped button in the middle for selecting and deselecting candidates and other ballot choices, selecting options in the audio and touch screen settings, and to print the ballot when prompted. Blue up and down arrows to the right of the red X button for navigating through instructions and candidate selections. Yellow left and right arrows to the left of the red X button to navigate through the contest and questions on the ballot, to access audio and touch screen settings, as well as to review selections and cast your ballot. Two small round orange buttons at the top right for changing the audio speed, two small square white buttons at the top left for adjusting the volume, and a long green help button across the bottom of the controller for pausing the voting session, getting instructions, or getting a poll worker's attention.
You can always press the green help button in a voting session to get help from any polling worker, and they'll come around and assist you.
For people with disabilities that impact dexterity, the keypad can accommodate sip and puff or paddle switches. The keypad can also be operated with one hand. There are two types of sip and puff devices, the headset device and the gooseneck device. The poll worker will assemble the unit with disposable gloves for your health and safety. Disposable straws are also used for sanitary purposes. The poll worker will connect the sip and puff to the device for you. The device is activated as long as the sip or puff is maintained. The sip and puff will enable the voter to choose by sipping on the straw and then selecting the preferred option by breathing into the tube slightly. Voters can then sip consecutively to confirm their choice and puff once the next button appears in order to advance the screen. To change a selection, voters can scroll through options by sipping consecutively and then puffing once their choice is selected.
A person uses a sip and puff straw to scroll through options on the screen.
You have selected
butter pecan.
For ballots that have a write-in option, the puff feature will activate an on-screen keypad that can be moved through via sipping to locate a desired letter and puffing to select one's choice.
You have reached the end of the ballot and the ballot is fully voted.
Yay! Says I've reached the end of the ballot.
All done.
All done.
Once the voter goes through the voting process using the keypad, they can review, edit, and verify their selections before casting their ballot. You'll be prompted to go to the ballot review screen. You'll then press the blue down arrow to go through each of your selections. When you've reviewed all of your selections, you'll be prompted to press the red X button to print your ballot. The built-in printer produces a marked paper ballot that serves as the official ballot record. The paper ballot is then tabulated by the voting machine the same as any other paper ballot.
A poll worker helps Andrea print and cast her ballot.
We're going to put it back in the machine like a regular ballot.
Okay. The ballot was successfully cast.
Andrea places an I voted sticker on her shirt as she exits the voting center.
Voting for me has been super empowering, and being able to access the vote in an accessible way is really helpful. Individuals with disabilities, it's extraordinarily important that we make our voice heard within society by casting our votes along with everyone else.
We hope that this video helped prepare you for using the ImageCast machine when you go to vote in upcoming elections. Thank you.
These materials were produced and funded by Access the Vote Florida and Disability Rights Florida Incorporated in association with Block by Block Creative through the Federal Protection and Advocacy for Voting Access Grant Program administered by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Administration for Community Living, and through additional support by the American Association of People with Disabilities.